Ryan Searle with Risk and Reward Farms here in Shelley, Idaho. We raise malt barley, some hard red and hard white spring wheat, as well as potatoes here in the southeast Idaho area. We farm roughly 2,400 acres with a little bit of custom on the side, so typically we're farming around 2,800 acres throughout the season. We have a good mixture of some clay loam, as well as we get all the way into some blow sand. So we have a lot of variety of soils on the farm, and our crops change throughout that. So we need a piece of equipment that can handle all types of soils very well, that is efficient, consistent, and to make sure that we get the best seed bed and seed placement as we go about our planting.
Hey Ryan, how's it going?
Good. Good to see you guys.
Good seeing you, Ryan. Richard and I are here. You called us.
Yeah.
And we just want to make sure we're want to look and see what some of your issues are that you're talking about this year for the planting.
Well, appreciate you guys coming out. As you guys know, we've been blessed this year, this fall, with a really good winter and a lot of snow, and it's given us a lot of moisture that we've in dire need of this year. But it's caused other issues that we've been fighting.
Yeah.
We're about a month behind due to the moisture that we have in the soil from getting our crops in the ground this year. So we need a solution that allows us to go in some wetter conditions that's going to be consistent across all of our soil types that we have on the farm.
Yeah.
It's going to make it so that we can just get the crop in the ground as quick as possible. So we need to be more efficient, but still keep the benefits that we saw with the compact Solitair, right? Where we're getting great seed placement,
yeah.
Right? We're getting a great mixture of the soil with that, right? But yet we're able to do that across more soil conditions that we have on our farm.
So how does that impact you though, by being that late?
So about every day that we're late, we're taking a bushel off. So we're talking 20 to 30 bushel decrease this year in yields potential. And every day that it takes us to get it in, that's just another bushel we're losing on the other end. So time's of the essence. We have a short window to get this crop in the ground. And because of that, now we're short manpower as well, because we've got other crops that we're trying to get in the ground at the same time. So we're stretched a little thinner. So we need something that we can come in, we can do a single pass, whether that's to interseed with some of our fall wheat crop that needs some help due to the winter, right? Some touch up.
Yep.
We might need to actually do a one pass destroy and replant on some of our winter stuff. But then on our spring crops, we need to come in. I don't have the equipment to come in and do any tillage work, so I need to have something that'll come in, take some of this harder soil that we have that's been compacted from the snowpack, that's wetter, that the conventional drills struggle and our conventional setups struggle to get through. You know, a conventional packer's gonna plug up coming through this.
Oh yeah, that's just really wet.
It's not gonna break the soil up very well, and it's gonna make for a really inconsistent seeding depth as we go through if we were using a conventional drill.
Hi, you must be Ryan, right?
I'm Ryan.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Martin from LEMKEN, Germany.
Nice to meet you, Martin.
Nice to meet you. I had your call for a better drill in Germany. And so I bought you our latest innovation from LEMKEN, our new DT drill. It's a drill combination, so it combines tillage, reconsolidation, and the seeding itself. So this is one of our latest innovations.
I'm excited to put it to work.
Oh yeah.
Thanks, Martin.
So now we come back here. This is one of the neatest features, Ryan. This trapeze packer roller right here is really the secret sauce.
So it's similar to what we had on the compact Solitair, but there's some changes that you've made to this roller, this packer.
You know, this packer is really innovative. So once before, we still had the space between the tires. That's why you still have this big drum right here. It's gonna push down that ridge and firm it up, right, in front of the seed rows. However, the rest of these behind the tire are gonna be more open, so you've got more flow ability for that material to flow through. So you're not gonna have any pressure issues, any bulldozing effect. And with it being a rubber like this, you're able to handle a lot more wet conditions like we're facing this year.
Yeah.
It's gonna really do a good job for it. And then we tried and true, our hydraulic down pressure, 5-inch row spacing. So our trapeze packer roller is at the 5-inch, right? So it's gonna give us that nice firm seed trench right in front. So when this unit comes down here, you got ideal seed to soil contact. You still have the hydrolyte down pressure with the 5-inch spacing. Each one of these row units is still gonna be the independent parallel linkage. So it's gonna just trail real fine. But the other nice features is we have larger size diameter hoses now.
Okay.
So we can handle more volumes of material.
Okay.
So when we go ahead and add like cover crops, or we've got 2-bin capacity, we can then do fertilizer and seed with this in the row unit. So okay. That way you're gonna have a lot more flexibility with this larger hose design as well.
This is gonna be a great addition to our farm. And I see the benefits. It's gonna make it more efficient. We're gonna get a better seeding, and hopefully it allows us to get the seed in this short window that we have this year.
I think so.
Ryan, let's come over here and look at the hopper.
Okay.
This thing's 144 bushel split bin. Or one thing that I like about these DTs is they got a 40-60 split, easy access, easy to change varieties from one variety to the next. And then these lids are super awesome because they keep the pressure in this drill for the excellent seeding that it has.
So Ryan, in order to guarantee the precise seeding rate of the DT, we have to calibrate the whole machine, and this is pretty simple to do. It's just a few steps and done in a few minutes.
Looks good, Richard. I'm excited.
You know, Ryan, it's always a good day with LEMKEN, you know?
All right, let's get to work.
You bet. Let's go check this out. You know, 16 days ago we were here.
Yeah.
Dry, long, wet spring.
Yeah.
Trying to get this crop in. How many days ago did this thing emerge?
So about 10 days after planting, it started popping. Yeah. So we're about 16 days out. And as you can see, you know, we've got some really good emergence here. Crop's looking great.
Yeah.
And, you know, we came into this spring behind schedule, but I don't think we're as far behind as we really think we are. So
that, you know, it's pretty amazing to see not only the seed depth, but look at our seeds here. I mean, look at that root structure we got.
Yeah.
The moisture's there. The roots are really taking off. They're in that nice firm soil, so they're not inhibited at all. I mean, look at how nice that looks. Well, Ryan, we appreciate everything you do for us. I've got something for you from LEMKEN, so give me a minute and I'll be right back.
Okay.
So Ryan, on behalf of LEMKEN, welcome to the L team.
Oh, thank you.
There's some hats. Here's a nice hoodie there.
Appreciate
you know,
that.
These cool mornings comes in pretty handy.
Well, thank you guys. Appreciate you, Richard.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Martin.
Nice meeting you.
Thanks, brother.
Thanks, Gert.